Hey, everybody. Let's find an appropriate pen to work this puzzle with. I haven't had this word seek puzzle book but just a few days. I've yet to work a puzzle. I'm going to use a ballpoint pen. And the other day I was going to use an Insignia ballpoint pen made by Parker. And I've got a handful of pens here. I thought I'd test them and see if they write. And this Insignia seems to write. And this one does as well. Another Insignia. Here's a burgundy Insignia. Here's a cross century. Here's another cross century. Here's a gold-plated Parker jotter. Here's a standard jotter. And here's a paper mate. Now, out of all of these pens, the one I want to write with, I've narrowed it down between this Parker Insignia in burgundy. Or this cross century in chrome. So it's a toss up. I think I'll just stick with a Parker. Word seek puzzles. February 2018. These are different than working a crossword. When I work a crossword, I usually search out a puzzle that it looks, one that looks like I can do. But here, all of the words that you are looking for are listed. So I think they're all pretty easy, I believe. So let's begin. This puzzle is entitled Be Mine. It's a Valentine's Day. It was immortalized on the big screen in a star-studded 2010 movie named For the Holiday of Hearts and Flowers. It's also the honored event in this word seek, whose list contains words about Valentine's Day cards. So let me scan the words real quick. Familiarize myself with what I'm looking for. Heroes is already circled. Cartoon. Colorful. Cupid. Cute. Flowers. Folded. Friend. Frilly. Glitter. Heart. Homemade. Keepsake. Lace. Letter. Mail. Paper. Picture. Pink. Poem. Red. Rhyme. Save. Saying. Send. Special. Teacher. Trim. Unique. White. Let's just start with a top line. Help me out all you want. I think these can be these are probably harder for me than a crossword puzzle because I have to try to spot patterns of letters like that's one right here. Friend. That's in the list. I'm going to turn the gain up just a little bit on the one of the mics. Maybe that way you can hear the pen on the paper. See, these words can go in any direction. Here's cute. going backwards. Cute, C-U-T-E. I still can't hear the pen there. Like I bit off more than I can chew with one of these puzzles. Here's lace. I spot the word home. If I continue on, it says made, homemade. That's one of the words. I immediately spotted poem. Cartoon fell right into my view. Backwards, but there it is. Flowers. Yes, flowers. Times when you see a consonant with a vowel, you gotta kind of not zoom in but zoom out your vision, and sometimes a word will pop right into your vision. Save. So remember, say there's So foul. I see Cupid. Here's the word seen, but it's not in the list. This is very, very tricky. Here's another saying. I saw this R-E, and I started to follow it down, but then I got down here and I saw the P, I started going back up, I stopped at P because there's two P's. Focusing on this area and trying to take an overall view. The word send pops right out at me. Rhyme. That was a tough one. Things are beginning to get a little bit cluttered in here at this point. DA. Red. Some people say red, and it sounds like they're saying rad. Little red Corvette. Hey, male right here. White. Thought we had another white here, but it's wit. Noog, N-O-O-G, but that's not in the list. Car, but that's not in the list either. Here's colorful. Colorful. Arrows started down. Let me scratch that out. I imagine some of you see some words that are yelling at your screen because I don't see the word. Keepsake. Okay, there's the rest of it. Keepsake. There's folded going upward. folded. Frilly glitter art letter. Suds. Pen is going dry. That spring, the cross century out of the bullpen. On an FRI. FRI. You gotta find the F first. F. That's not it. Look for another F. And when you find the F, look for an R and an I. And if you don't find it, start again. F, R, E. F, R, I, E. F. R, C. F, R, O. F, R, G. It is at the very bottom, FRILLY. Now let's get heart. H-E-A. H-E-R. H-K. H A. H A. H. Looking for an H-E-A. And I don't see it. So I'll start at the top again. H-E-I. H-E-R. H. There it is. H-E-A-R-T. Heart. Now we're looking for the letter L-E-T-T. First we need L-E. L-E-U. L-E-R. L-E-C. L-O that way. L-O that way. I saw two T's, and that led me to look closer, and here it is, letter. Now we need picture, or pink, so a P-I-C, or a P-I-N. So we need to find the letter P. P. And there's pink right there. portrait picture. There's a peep, no eyes. But no eyes. Pee, but no eyes. Pee, I, you. P-I-S-H. P-I-R P-I-V There it is, right there at the bottom, going diagonally to the left picture. Now we need special, S-P-E-C, S-P, oh, that was easy, here it is, S-P-E-C-I-A-L, special, teacher, T-E-A is what we need. Stop at a T. T. E. T. Looking for that T. E. A. T. E. R. We need trim, T-R-I-M, and there it is right there at the top, trim. Now we need unique, U-N-I, U-N-S, U-N, there it is at the top, U-N-I. Well, that was fun. Good exercise for my brain. Very nice. If you want to see more of these, word seeks, tell me in the comments. Show you these pins close up. Let me adjust the focus. This is a cross century, and this is also a cross century. Parker made the insignia to do battle with a cross century. The cross century takes 3/4 of a turn to make the ball come out. Parker wanted to improve upon that, so they made theirs come out with one half of a turn. So you could easily open it up with just one hand. Here's the Parker insignia that I was using that went dry. Here's another insignia in black. And another. I'm really not sure what this finish is. I don't know if it's like a lacquered silver. Probably not. I'm not sure. And here's the inexpensive paper mate. Here's a early 80s jotter made by Parker. And another jotter. This one is gold plated, vintage 1982. Vintage 1980, I believe. This paper made, I have no idea. The insignias were introduced in 1991, and I think this is a 91. This insignia is a what you call custom burgundy. This is a 1997 pen. Here's a black lacquer. I'm not sure what year this is, was, or is. And I have two of these, thanks to my wife. My wife used to have a pen fetish. So some of these pens used to be hers. But now they're mine. Insignias were made from 1991, and they were discontinued in 98. They made the insignia because they needed a pen that they could sell in the $10 to $100 gift range. So Parker commissioned an outfit named Hollington and Associates, or Hollington Associates, I think is what it's called. They're in England, London. The same guy that designed the Parker sonnet and the Parker 100 also designed the insignia. This guy named Jeff Hollington. A very, very talented pen designer. But other than that, he's got a pretty messed up life. I'm not going to go into the details. You can look it up yourself. Most of you are probably asleep by now. But if you're not, the secret word for this video is gonna be, I'm looking in front of me on a shelf for something to use as the secret word. Let's see. I see something. Let me reach up. Let me carefully reach up and get it. Here's a harmonica. This one is a blues harp in the key of G. And I like to piddle around with this. I'm not very good at it. It's still kind of fun. I've had this harmonica since the 80s. It was a gift from somebody. So the secret word is harmonica. Not even sure I can spell it. Okay, so until next time.